All right, and we're back. New notification. Oh, DLC. So, last time we had just finished chapter 5, which was kind of crazy. Lots of destruction, lots of death, and dragon. So now we're moving on to chapter 6 and hopefully conquest proper. Weren't they fighting on a different island in the prologue? I could be wrong. And one thing I want to clarify on the interface spoilers I mentioned in chat, just because I felt like talking about it, that I noticed those enemies from the last chapter. I feel like their art style isn't quite Norian. I felt the same way about Yago. So I have a feeling there's something else going on with them, especially since their leader was using a Hoshido sword, and they were not. This is using a bit of meta knowledge of the series, but the enemies were not named for their faction; they were simply called Invader. So I have a feeling that Diego's got his own faction that's pulling the strings behind Garen for their own gain. Well, they probably wouldn't even call it Invader if it was an actual Noir-aligned squad. They simply would have called it Noir or Narian. Something like that. Just like with, they'd call Hoshido troops Hoshido.
Let us begin.
I suppose that's true with the Risen, but I mean, at the same time, I'm not really sure if I'd call a Risen Plaguean aligned. It's more like the Risen are Grima's faction, and the Plagueans are even subordinate to the Risen, really. In like looking at the whole chain of command as a whole. Well, I guess not really chain of command, but chain of power, maybe.
Stay alert.
Big Brother. Oh.
You have the Devil's own luck.
Yay! Norian scum!
Don't be fooled.
Yes, be careful, even though you've explained to us that you've lived with Nora for a long time. Still uncomfortable here with being fought over like an object, though.
This way.
Big sister! She's my sister!
We're your family.
Yes, no mere commander, he's a prince. I like how the game also goes ahead and tells me you don't have the data for this. No, really. Thanks for being so metagame.
Can't be.
I am so sorry.
What?
How can you say that? I mean, we practically just met, but we totally expected you to side with us. Really? So the Japanese version, well, digital version, made the choice kind of actually a choice going into the chapter instead of being pre-purchased. I wonder why they didn't do that for this, for the North American release.
No.
No.
Yeah, Ryomen. Who kidnapped Azura? Huh?
Everything's okay.
Shut up, Xander. We need to have a chat after this. Well, someone's coming across as a bit of a psycho now.
Show no mercy. Waiting for this.
Hello, the bunk can't swim. I don't really do low turn count anymore. I used to back before streaming was a thing, but like, I don't know, it was fun for a bit, but I feel like low turn count isn't something I can really put a lot of effort into. So if you're asking if I'm gonna low turn count this in the future, I guess it depends on how much I like the game. Yeah, this is a pretty heavy guilt trip chapter from both sides. And also, I'm glad you see where I'm coming from too, Kat. Both sides have definitely made me pretty uncomfortable with that. Enough of foolish words. You've been the only one spouting foolishness, Ryoma.
Let us begin.
No.
No. Know this.
Or worse, that we coerced you into joining us? I'm not seeing the logic there, Leo. Yeah, this is a chance to prove beyond a doubt through murder.
No option.
Aw, yeah!
Why is this line even in here? Also, if we retreat, we won't get to curb stop to Takumi. I guess that's a good point, Konk.
You have breathed your last. Prepare yourself. A
Allow me to join you.
Where have you been, Jacob? Defeat four enemies, huh? Okay, so he doesn't have all the skills he did before. The elixir only has one use. And it only heals 40 hit points. Oh wow, I actually get a status stave. Well, I suppose they've given away stuff like sleep staves in my past, but usually they're really rare, so that's interesting. Malignite. That's a really strange command. Which one was this one? Oh, it's the total opposite of what Camila provides. So this was a map light skill, I guess, huh? So his ability is not going to apply. Thinking you might try ganging up on Ryoma first. Although it'll certainly make it easier for the other two here to reach me. And Hinoka will be able to reach anywhere regardless of what I do. Guess I should actually look at my, let's see. Don't think I looked at Leo at all either. Heartseeker is nice, but probably not something I should try using against Ryoma. Okay. Makes me curious here. She's got basically no damage at range. Actually, let's see. If people are all jumping on him, he's got his 1-2 range sword. That definitely complicates things. Well, so not everyone here is gonna have... Yeah, not everyone here is going to have enough luck to negate Ryoma's crit rate. Also, my defense and res are debuffed for some reason. Ooh, those Dragon Sand penalties are steep. Okay, so part of this is probably gonna hinge on which direction the middle characters go. Because if Hinoka actually ends up charging in, it may be advantageous to wait a few turns so we can isolate her. I pretty much can't afford to let Ryoma initiate. Because we're going to be missing all the time if he does. Definitely confused why having the Yato equipped seems to have my Deef and Rez debuff though. I guess I forgot to mention that it debuffs me. Alright, pretty much everyone here is going to not want Tanoka to initiate on them because she'll double. Actually, forget initiating, she'll pretty much double everyone who isn't Dusky if she engages them. So what I'm thinking is we'll move north, and they may move south. If they do, and Hinoka decides to chase me, I will probably leave the battle as is up here for a bit while I deal with them. But if they start moving north, I think I'll have to Dragon's Vein. I could also send Camila to pair up with him. What does she provide? The only thing that would be relevant would be defense. Which would still, it would give him, nah, it wouldn't even give him an extra hit. still, it's worth considering. I could also initiate on him offensively. So Leo can survive combat with Herm and not Jacob. And there's also the threat of swapping to Takumi. So I don't think either way lure tactics probably aren't going to be a good idea against them. Sure, what's her defense look like? Somewhat poor, but not exactly trivial. And I guess at least if we can take Hinoka out, if Takumi has to get a turn, as long as Camille is nowhere near him, same with Elise, he shouldn't be able to kill anyone. What we'll do is keep everyone separated for now. Just in good positions to react to what the enemy does. And I guess I'm stuck with a heal staff with only one range. If I'm going to initiate on him at all, actually I could go for it right now if I wanted. I have a good setup. gonna do 14 and then cut in half to 1. 15 total. We could get it up to 24. Eleven was 26. Nah, never mind. Bursting them down right now is not gonna work. He has too much hit points, and I can't dogpile him because his counter attacks are gonna wreck like half the team. So we're probably gonna have to let Xander and Riona fight it out a bit here. Let's loop up his. Alright, elbow room. And then even so, we would, even counting the 5 extra damage, we wouldn't have enough to take him out just yet. Only 76 to hit, huh? Can we maybe do something about that with Camille's increased magic? 2 extra percent. Totally worth, guys. Yeah, apparently there's no Lunatic Plus on this game. Alright, well, I hate that this is a bit of a luck roll, but what can you do?
Huh?
I will be amazed if Xander hits us at all. They were smart enough to approach in a way that I can't hem Takumi in. Although I don't. Yeah, I don't think most base classes can go on water. Actually, they may have hemmed themselves in worse. Okay, if I want to use Camila at all, she's pretty much got to be leading, attacking from one space away. Otherwise, Takumi is going to wreck her and wreck her badly. His is all damage reduction. Let's hear your other one again. Yeah, I can't afford to make use of that unless I want her to get shot. So I can bump that up to 9, and right, and 17 should be enough. Thank you. I guess Leo's aura doesn't apply when he is on the back. Or, oh, it must just be for him. I think. Really not keen on the level of risk this presents if I can't get his aura. Alright, good night, Luigi Silver. Thanks for popping by. Should definitely be in danger if I don't get this kill. Actually, if I don't land the freeze, she'd be in danger of getting gibbed by Takumi if I can't get the kill. There's a lot of risk here. I mean, I guess, like, I can always restart the chapter if it doesn't work out, but it feels kind of cheap to think of it that way. But if I don't do something about them now, there's a chance that they'll also just, like, run over here and start attacking Xander and gang up on him with Ryoma. And I really don't want that either. So, guess making the best of a worse situation, I probably have to be aggressive here. Now both these have to hit.
What's the meaning of this?
can handle this.
I refuse to accept this.
Oh, that's bad. Seems kind of cheap that doesn't have a man. Well, there's pretty much no salvaging this now. I could have. Well, there's a chance of aborting, but it's not going to be good. Yeah, definitely gonna have to rethink that one. So, pinning him over water didn't work, because he gets a get-out-of-jail-free card. Thank you. Okay, we want to not encourage them to go north. But I don't think I want to try luring them over either. So let's see if that will draw them over. Meanwhile, see if we can get Xandu the first strike again. That's more like it. Okay, he can take several hits from her if need be, so it's safe for him to attack. He could potentially do more damage if someone were to injure her, but he's the one with the best chance to hit. Plus, he has a Heartseeker aura. Do I need to use the freeze staff now? Actually, yeah, I should be able to double though. I think. Well, let's see. Darting Blow would give her 19. Yeah, that doubles pretty much everyone here. So I need to try to make this work out. I don't want to burn through the freeze staff in one map, but... seems like if I want to have the best chance of success, I kind of need to. Getting RNG'd so bad here. Thank you. Okay, at least the 90s doing this.
I'm here to help.
So I guess those magic points before are actually helpful because dragon. Prepare to pay. I don't know about you, Takumi, but I don't think you can do anything. Yeah, I'm running speed plus speed minus luck, Shadow Zero. Let's see, if we go to the woods here, and he decides to... attack me at range, let's say from here. That puts him in. Puts him in range of being attacked. I just realized, though, one thing I probably could have done turn one is paired Xander onto Camilla and booked it out of there. Assuming you can actually pair the Paladin to a flying unit. I guess it'll take a turn for everyone to take out Takumi and then make their way back up. So I'm pretty much bound to using the elixir. So I almost might as well go for the woods play because I don't think I'll have Elise use a freeze next turn. And Xander's not gonna have a very good chance of dodging, but might as well stack it. Leo would just explode him completely. Ligri right now. He's level 1 promoted, so... the game could maybe be worthwhile for him. In any event, it would allow me to pick up a pace here and come help Xander out. Tree branch spell? I guess I should have noticed that the first time, but... oh, I guess no one else gains experience here. That's unfortunate. But time is of the essence, so I think it was still worth it.